dream since I was a child. I debuted in 2008. I never had a single title match for the WWE Championship until WrestleMania. You know, a couple weeks before WrestleMania 2, I had one. But this has always been my dream. And I feel like if I would have won when I first debuted, it wouldn't have been as meaningful as it is now. You know, like I said, everything happens for a reason. So a lot of stars lined up. I had to wait 11 years to become WWE champion. I finally become WWE champion. It's been 26 years since I've been here to Ghana. 26 years later, I do all of this. This is the year of the return. Out of all the years that this could possibly be, it's the year of the return. So I feel like everything happened for this moment, you know, and I'm just so thankful that in coming here, that I've been welcomed with open arms. It's just been all love, you know, and I'm just so appreciative of that. All the hard work that has gone into this. You know, my mom and I have had conversations back and forth for years about me wanting to come here, and then myself with the WWE schedule not having the time. Finally, here we are. You know, it's amazing. It's amazing to be here, and I'm just so fortunate to be in the position to inspire others. I think above all else, you know, when I was a kid, this is what I wanted to do. It's awesome that I was able to achieve my childhood dream, but what's even more important than that is for me to come back and inspire people who might be exactly where I was as a little kid, watching, hoping to be something. I am living, breathing proof that you can be whatever it is that you want to be. Like I said, you think about a WWE superstar and a wrestler, a lot of times people look at me and they say, oh, you're not 6'8", you know, you're not 300 pounds, you know. I'm not the prototypical WWE superstar, let alone champion. Like I said, my inner chest is all sternum, no pectoral muscle whatsoever. My legs are very skinny. I don't care, you know what I mean? I'm not the tallest, I'm not the strongest, but somehow, some way, I'm sitting here before you, talking to you about my journey to becoming WWE champion. So, again, providing the inspiration to people who want to become something and you don't quite know if you can do it, I'm here to let you know that you can do it if you believe in yourself. Like I said, I'm living, breathing proof. So I'm glad. I'm just so happy and honored to be here and honored to be in this position where I can inspire other people and inspire other Ghanaians to go out and do great things in this world. So I'm here. Thank you for welcoming me.
The mother of the moment. Put your hands together for her one more time.
Thank you all so very much. I'm not going to take too much time because the reason we are here is here. Kofi, it seems when you were talking, you don't give yourself that much credit. You know, you're good. You're tough. You may not be the tallest, the strongest, like you're saying, the biggest, like you said, but you're the fastest. And you're the best gymnast. Yes. And he learned gymnastics from when he was little, acro gymnastics. That's all coming in to help out. So I'm real, real proud, and I thank you all for coming out. I thank you for the wonderful, wonderful reception that you gave him, a rousing welcome. I couldn't be prouder as a mother.
For Kofi. And I want to say, welcome home. It's been a long time. I've been watching you from since I was a kid. So it's so great to be here, seeing you live with you.
I'm envious of your artistic talent. You are so talented, man. Thank you so, so much for this. This is incredible. Thank you. I'll hang this up in my house for sure, man. Thank you.
So ladies and gentlemen, we're doing a countdown from 5 to 0. 5, 4, 3,